Hey everybody, today we're going to be talking to you about something that is close to Deb and I's heart, and that is responsible travel.
And we're going to talk to you about all the different ways that you can make your travels more responsible and meaningful when you travel the world. Recently, Dave and I took a pledge to reduce our plastic waste. The World Travel and Tourism Council is trying to get people to make the world a better place by doing little things that can make a huge difference. Because when there's millions of people out there being more responsible, we can make the world a better place.
I think everybody knows that plastic is a huge problem in the world. I remember seeing it the first time when we were traveling in Asia, when we were in Cambodia, and some guy asked for a Coke, and he took the Coke, poured it into a plastic bag, put a plastic straw on it, threw the can in the river and gave us the plastic bag. And when we looked over at the river, it was just like, just a sea of plastic bags. So it's been a problem for a very long time.
I know that a lot of people think when they're traveling, they can't do a lot when it comes to plastic. Yeah. But you do not have to drink bottled water. Even if you are worried about contaminated water, there are ways that you can do it without having to buy plastic bottled water.
One of the ways that you can do it is there's a ton of water purifiers out there. You can either get tablets, the SteriPen, or you can get an actual water bottle that has a filtration system in it, which is what we really recommend because it's refillable. You can bring it with you wherever you go, and it gives you access to clean water no matter where you are.
Yeah, Life Straw is very popular, and we use the Katadyn system. You fill it with water, and then you squeeze the water through a filtration system, and when you drink it, you have pure water. So you don't have to have all of those plastic bottles just going into the oceans.
Another thing we recommend is to bring your own canvas bag. So when you go down to the store and they offer you a plastic bag, then you can just put it in your own little canvas bag. It's kind of like you do at home already. You know, you can't really get plastic bags in a lot of places. So why not carry on that tradition when you're traveling?
This is a huge problem in developing countries. When we were cycling Africa, we saw so many thorn trees just covered in plastic bags. It was really sad to see. And a lot of that is because of tourists. It's us that are really contributing to the filth and the mess out there. Something that is really close to our hearts is wildlife. We have seen wildlife be abused and traumatized and troubled by tourism in the past, and it's time that we as tourists really start taking responsibility.
Definitely one of the main things out there that have been in the news is elephant rides, whether it be in Thailand or any other of those, or India or any of the other Asian countries. You know, please, if you can, don't ride elephants. Or if you're going to go and to see elephants and you want to see them in the wild or you want to see them, go to a sanctuary. We did that when we were in Thailand, where they take rescued elephants that have been abused or that were former logging elephants and you know.
And tourist riding elephants as well. They were saved and they were brought into a sanctuary so that they could live out their life in peace once and for all. And your tourist dollars go to actually helping the elephants rather than harming them.
So make sure you do your research and find out, you know, what travel company you're going with right there. They do offer elephant rides, then make sure to ask the questions and say, hey, you know what, I don't agree with this and I'm not going to take the tour because of that. Because if we all take a stand, then we could all make a change.
Another thing that is very popular out there is swimming with dolphins. If you see enclosed dolphins and they offer rides where you can go and swim with the dolphins and ride on their fins and get involved and up close and personal with them, just don't do it. Dave and I have swam with dolphins many times in the wild, and you know what? They love human encounters. When they have the choice, if you are out in the wild and you're in the middle of the ocean and dolphins see you, they're going to come and they're going to play with you and circle around you and jump up and down. So if you do swim with dolphins, do it when you're out on a snorkeling excursion. But please, do not touch them, do not reach out, just let them come to you.
So it really comes down to two things. It comes down to, one, you actually speaking up and saying something, and two, doing your research and making sure that the companies that you're going with and the tour operators you're going with are environmentally friendly and they're not, you know, harassing or corralling the animals as well. Yeah, we've seen that where they're like trying to corral them into one area for tourists or, you know,
chasing
boats or chasing them
or getting too close.
There's just so many ways that you can affect an animal in its natural habitat. And you know, they don't necessarily have a voice, but you do. So us speaking up and telling the operators and telling the tour companies that it's not okay will help that change.
Yeah, so keep your distance, go out to the wildlife and observe. And if they come to you and they're curious, that's great, but please don't chase them.
Another way that you can contribute to responsible travel is to make sure that you hire local guides. I know when we climbed Mount Kilimanjaro, we hired local guides. When we went up to Mount Everest Base Camp, we made sure we had local guides that we hired right there on the ground. So you're employing and actually contributing directly to the local economy.
So there's nothing wrong with going with a tour company. We do it all the time. We're going to Africa with Go Ahead Tours, and we know that they hire local guides because we did a trip to Scandinavia with them where we had our one local guide, Derek, who was fantastic. He was from Europe, but every time we got to a different country or city in Scandinavia, a local guide joined us, and they told us about the local customs, and they led the group, and it was amazing. And I think that's really important to talk to the tour company and say, do you hire local guides on the ground, and do you support the local economy? And that's a really important thing to do.
Another way that you can contribute to traveling responsibly is to honor local customs. I can't tell you how many times I have gone into temples in Thailand or Burma, Myanmar, you know, where, you know, women and men are not dressed appropriately just because they haven't taken the time to educate themselves on the local customs and local religion. And, you know, really, to be able to go in and see these places is one thing, but you have to honor their way of life. Now, we talked about water at the beginning, but I just want to talk about it a little bit more, especially when you're traveling to countries where, you know, water is an issue or lack of water is an issue. You can do your best to conserve water. You don't have to be in there and take a 20-minute shower in a place like Sudan where they're struggling for water. Try and limit your showers down to maybe 3 minutes, 4 minutes, or you know what, just, you know, take less showers. You don't have to shower every single day, especially when you're traveling, unless you really want to offend your spouse. Do your best to conserve water while you're traveling.
Another thing you can do is to support the local economy. I find that a lot of times people are stuck on the resort or stuck on the cruise ship, and they only seem to buy their drinks on the cruise and their food at the resort, and they don't get out and support the local economy. But you know what? Those street vendors and those local shops, they depend on your money, and you're gonna get something way more authentic, and that's just a lot of heart and soul went into it, and you're gonna save a lot of money. So to sum up traveling responsibly, there are so many things you can do. Just think about the local customs, think about the wildlife, think about the conservation and the nature of the area. You know, it's just common sense. The way you want your home to be is exactly how you want your travels to be. So we hope that we gave you some ideas on how you can make the world a better place. And go to our website and read about it. There's a link below about how we are taking the pledge, and we give you other ideas about how you can take the pledge as well.
And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to subscribe and come back each week, because we put new videos up every week.
You never know what you're gonna get.